हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, फॉर क्लास 10 कंप्यूटर एप्लीकेशंस टुडे विल स्टार्ट विद चैप्टर 1 दैट इज रिवाइजिंग बेसिक जावा कॉन्सेप्ट्स। इन दिस चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी रादर वी आर गोइंग टू रिवाइज the basic Java concepts, all the things which you have learned in class 9. Topic wise, let us see all those things which we have learned last year. Introduction to OOP, that is object oriented programming concepts. Introduction to Java, elementary concepts of objects and classes, values and data types, operators and expressions, mathematical library functions, conditional constructs in Java, input in Java, iteration constructs in Java, and nested loops. Let us see one by one. Introduction to object-oriented programming. There are certain definitions which you need to learn, which you learned last year, but we need to revise them. Abstraction is an OOP principle, an act of representing essential features without including background details. Encapsulation, wrapping up of data and functions into a single unit called class. Modularity, property of decomposing a system into a set of cohesive and loosely coupled modules. Inheritance, capability of one class of things to inherit properties from another class. And polymorphism, this is an ability for a message or data to be processed in more than one form. Next, we had introduction to Java. We studied about bytecode. It's an intermediate code or machine instruction for a Java processor chip called JVM. What is JVM? Java Virtual Machine. It's an abstract machine that executes Java bytecode. We studied about two types of Java applications, internet applets and standalone applications. Then we studied about BlueJ. BlueJ is an IDE, that is Integrated Development Environment, to create Java applications. Then elementary concepts of objects and classes. Basically, OOP is object-oriented programming. So we have to learn about objects and classes. So what is an object? It is an identifiable entity with some characteristics and behavior. And what is a class? It's a blueprint or group of objects that share common properties. It is an object factory which produces different objects. Base class. It's a class whose properties are inherited by other classes. And derived class is a class which inherits properties from its base class. And the relation between objects and a class. Objects are the instances or examples of a class. Then we had values and data types. We had token. What is a token? It is the smallest individual unit of a Java program. Java program is made up of tokens. Then we had different type of tokens like keywords, identifiers, literals, operators and separators, in short kilos. Then we studied about two types of data types. One is primitive and other is non-primitive or reference data types. In primitive data types we have 8 types of data types. that are bytes, short, integer, long, float, double, character and boolean. Then we studied about variables. What are variables? They are named memory locations or storage locations whose values can be changed during the program run. And what are constants? These are the values assigned to variables which do not change their values. Then we studied about operators and expressions. What are operators? Operators are symbols that trigger some operations. Types of operators, we had three types of operators, basically arithmetic operators, relational operators and logical operators. In relational operators, we have greater than, less than and so on. Logical operators, we have and, or and not. Other operators like assignment operator, equals to sign, single equals to sign, conditional or ternary operator, dot operator, new operator, increment or decrement operators. Then what is an expression? Expression in Java is a combination of operators, constants and variables or Java tokens. Type conversion. It's the way by which we can convert the data, one data type into another data type. There are two types of type conversion: implicit, it's also called coercion, and explicit, also called typecasting. We studied about mathematical library functions. Java provides number of classes which are predefined or built in different packages. These library functions help us to work in Java. And math class is one such predefined class which is a part of Java language package. Java language package is the default package. Math class makes available many mathematical functions. This table shows you the different functions and the format or the syntax which we use and the description about each and every function. Like power function, it returns x raised to the power y. SQRT, it returns the square root of x. CBRT, returns the cube root of x. Seal, it returns the smallest number greater than or equal to x. Floor, it returns the largest number which is less than or equal to x. ABS, that is, it returns the absolute value of x. Max, which returns the maximum of x and y. Minimum, mean, that is, returns the minimum of x and y. Round, which returns the value of x rounded to the nearest whole number. And the random function, which returns a random value. It's a double value between 0 and 1. Then we studied about conditional constructs in Java. You know, children, computer works with the help of a program, and program is nothing but a set of statements, and these statements are executed in different order. They may be executed in sequential order, in selectively or iteratively. Conditional constructs means when the statements are executed depending upon a condition. We use if and switch statements to implement conditional constructs. Conditional constructs help us to make decisions in a program. That's why it's also called decision construct. With the help of this flowchart, you can understand what are the conditional or selection constructs. You can see there is a condition checked, and depending upon the condition, if it is true, this statement 1 and statement 2 are executed and we proceed further. In case if it is false, then we follow the other path. Statement 1 and statement 2 are executed and we proceed further. Then we have iteration constructs in Java. Iteration, also called looping constructs, means when a set of statements are executed repeatedly. So iteration construct creates a loop in Java. There are four parts of loops, very important. One is initialization expression, test expression, update expression, and body of the loop. Every loop has got these four parts. There are three types of loops in Java: for loop, while loop, and do while loop. For and while, these two loops are called entry control loops because we check the condition before we enter the loop. And do while is exit control loop because the condition is checked when we exit, when we come out of the loop. With the help of this flowchart, you can understand there is a condition checked in the beginning. If it is true, then we are executing statement 1 and statement 2 and we get back to the condition to be checked once again. So these two statements, statement 1 and statement 2, are repeatedly executed unless and until this condition becomes false. Once the condition becomes false, we exit the loop. So these two statements are the loop of the body. Then nested loops. A loop inside another loop. So when a loop is inside another loop, it is called nested loop. For every value of outer loop, first the inner loop is completed, then outer loop. Nested loops are used to print different patterns. In your programming, you will use nested loops to create patterns. Break statement terminates the loop or jumps out of the innermost enclosing loop. And continue statement skips the current iteration of a loop. With the help of this flowchart, you can understand. The first condition, if it is true, we are to execute the statement 1 and we are going to check another condition. And if it is false, then we are to execute these two statements and we get back to check this condition once again. So this creates a loop here. If this condition is false, then these two statements will be repeatedly executed and it forms what is called inner loop. So this is the inner loop. Once this condition is false, if it is true, then we are getting back to the first condition. And if this is true, then again we come down and again we execute this inner loop. That is why for every value of outer loop, inner loop is completed first and then we complete the outer loop. And if the outer loop is false, then we exit. And so here, from here to here, we have the outer loop. Then input in Java. For taking inputs in Java, we use different packages. We need to import. What are packages? Package is a collection of related classes which contain number of functions. And import command is used to make available all the classes defined in a package into another package. There are different packages like input-output package, AWT, utility. So one example is import java.util.scanner. So here import command is used to make available all the classes, especially scanner class here, which is from utility package. There are two types of program errors. There are three types of program errors: syntax error, semantic errors, and logical errors. According to the time or phase of error detection, when they are detected, there are two types of errors: compile time error and run time error. Okay, with this we conclude chapter 1. We have seen all the things which you have learned last year in brief. And let me remind you certain things. Kindly go through the study material set 2, which is uploaded in the school website. It is the solution of section A, second term, second semester exam last year, 2020. And this is the question paper. If you solve this question paper thoroughly, you'll be able to revise all the topics which you have learned in class 9, especially the programming part. You can take the help of textbook. There are 52 solved examples and programs at last of your book in miscellaneous programs part. Now let me clear about internal assessment. You have got now 15 days and more. You can complete these assignments and project. There are two assignments. Assignment 1 is based on your holiday assignments which you are given. There were 3 programs given. So those 3 programs you will write as your assignment 1. The assignment 2 will be based on chapter 1. You have to solve the question from chapter 1, page 26, section A, objective type question, all question, and page 35 assignment. Question number 40 to 53, there are more than 10 programs, at least 15 programs are there. So any 10 programs you have to write as assignment 2. And the project work is on Java programming. You have to solve all the programming questions only of section B of the given question paper, your second semester exam 2020. Write the question with the question number and the program together. Okay. So see you in the next video. Till then, take care. And stay home, stay safe. Bye.